So the U.S. Equal Employment Opportunity Commission sued a waste management company after Black and Haitian American employees alleged that they were subjected to a hostile work environment. So the EEOC filed a lawsuit on behalf, let's say, of the employees of Waste Pro of Florida. It was filed on Tuesday, September 26. It said Fentanyl Pierre, it said he, who served as a welder, was working at the Jacksonville location. Say he was continuously harassed, say, by his colleagues. According to the lawsuits, his co-worker identified as William Watts allegedly called him and said the N-word, said go back to Haiti, and said there is no need for you here. Say he also told to go back, say, to the banana boat, and this is Trump country. Said Pierre, say, expressed his concerns to his supervisor, but the lawsuit alleged no disciplinary action was taken. Say in March 2022, less than a year after working at the location, he was approached by a supervisor who told him Watts and another co-worker named Mr. Schumann used racially offensive language. And say when talking about him, he reported the harassment again, and say which was sent through human resources and prompted an investigation. Now, Pierre continued to report his experience and say and expressed that he feared retaliation from his co-workers amid the probe into his claims. His lawsuit stated that when the company didn't take action, he requested to work at a later time. However, he still had to work with Mr. Watts and Mr. Schumann as if for an hour each day. So according to court records, he was also requested that it is not disclosed that he reported the racial discrimination claims, but Watts was informed. Anyway, it said by the regional HRN Riser. Riser also announced that there would be a staff meeting to address Pierre's concerns after the investigation was concluded. It said before the staff meeting, Pierre and another Black employee discovered a stuffed monkey is carrying an American flag in Mr. Pierre's work areas. Mr. Pierre, it said, immediately reported the monkey incident to management and demanded the stuffed monkey be removed. And management reviewed video footage and conducted an investigation into the matter. However, no corrective action was taken before the staff meeting. So they just letting the white supremacy run wild at this particular job. So the harassment by Watson and Schumann continued. It said Pierre felt like he was slighted, ignored, and given the most challenging task. It said he decided to quit. About 2 weeks later, said a lawsuit is seeking in part punitive damages for Black and Haitian American employees, said due to the malicious and reckless conduct of the company. So we just covered one about Tesla, now this particular company. These people just don't really get it that they're going to have to pay out the nose for their racism. But these people believe racism is so worth it that they're cool with actually paying for it. And that's fine. That's why I tell any Black person on a job, you see any kind of racism, go make a case with the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. Make you a case. They will sue on your behalf, and that's what they're there for. Because no one should be going through this on any kind of job. These people, like I told you, that's their culture. So to tell them they can't be racist is telling them they can't be who they really are.